Hallelujah. How many knows it's a privilege to be back in the house of the Lord on a Sunday morning? He delivered us, he saved us, and he gave us a good path to walk.
Yes.
Gave us a good life and gave us an abundant life.
Hallelujah.
If you're a visitor here at Solid Rock, we want to welcome you. We invite you just to join right on in and worship our Lord and King Jesus.
Yes.
Let's give him a hand clap this morning.
Shout of praise this morning. Come on. Hallelujah. How many knows he's a good God this morning? Hallelujah. It's a privilege and an honor to be in the house of the Lord this morning. And amen. We welcome you. Amen. Right now, would you just raise your hands towards heaven? And amen. Let's welcome the sweet presence of God and ask him to touch your hearts and our lives this morning. And amen. Those that would be lost, God would save this morning. Come on. Let's just reach out to heaven this morning. Hallelujah. Let's remember little Bella's in the hospital in Louisville. Ask God to touch her. Mother Calvin Gray is going back in the hospital. Ask God to touch Mother Calvin this morning. And all those that need a touch of heaven this morning, come on, let's cry out to God. Let's touch the heart of God this morning for the lost loved ones and for those that need a heaven's touch. Father, we thank you this morning. God, we need you this morning more than anything in this world. God, would you touch our hearts, touch our lives this morning. Oh, mighty God, we welcome you this morning. Touch every heart. Give us a heart to understand, a hunger for you this morning, Lord. God, we praise you for saving the lost, healing that sick this morning. God, I praise you for it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Would you worship for a moment on this song? Hallelujah. Come on in this morning. Come on in to worship the Spirit of God. Hallelujah.
Of trouble.
Dreaming at all, then my dear.
sang it with us this morning. Thank you, Lord. Knows that's very true this morning. Amen. There's no peace outside the Prince of Peace. Come on, let's give the Lord a shout of praise this morning. Amen. Aren't you glad to be in church this morning? How many of y'all glad to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Amen. Amen. Turn around. Amen. Won't say it's good to have Brother and Sister Nail with us from up in Michigan. Amen. They come by to visit this morning. Brother, amen, Larry and Sister Sharon. Amen. Give them and the Lord a good hand this morning. So good to have y'all. God bless you. Amen. We was with them Friday night. Amen. And God's just a mighty good God. Go across the aisle. Shake your neighbor's hand right now. Tell somebody, say, good to see you. Amen. Shake Brother Larry and Sister Sharon's hand. Tell them it's good to have them with us this morning. Amen. Let's sing. Give me Kid G. Kid G. Really once was lost in sin. Oh, but Jesus took me in. And then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It made my heart in love, and it wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it all right.
Now let us have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer return, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Sometimes my bad dreams drear without a ray of cheer. And then a little cloud of doubt may hide the light of day. The mist of sin may rise and hide the starry sky. But just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us,
come on, talk.
Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you, hallelujah, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. I may have doubts and fears, my eyes be filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer, he knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him, come on, sing it, church.
He will hear our faintest cry.
When you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. One more time, everybody. Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us share all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. Sometimes the past seems drear without a ray of cheer. And then a little cloud of doubt may hide the light of day. The mist of sin may rise and hide the starry sky. But just a little talk with Jesus. Come on, everybody. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little
prayer, you know a little fire is burning.
You will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little power of turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right.
Well, let's give the Lord a great big shout of praise this morning. Come on, hallelujah. I said, let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all. Yes, he will. My God, touch him. Hallelujah.
Find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our trouble. Hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right.
We'll give the Lord a shout of praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, give God a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Somebody was talking a while back and said anybody that wanted to have a two-week revival was out of their minds. They turned around and said, I've got 3 months of sports. I forgot what kind of said my kids in sports said, I've got 3 months of three nights a week, and for 3 months, that wasn't out of their mind. I thought, you're plumb crazy. That went over like a ton of brick. If I'm out of my mind for going to church, amen, they plumb crazy. Tell them, I tell your neighbor, God's still good this morning. Come on, somebody ought to give God a little shout of praise. It's still the truth anyhow. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God a praise. Amen. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our trouble. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right.
Well,
one more time, give your God a great big shout of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, yes.
Oh, but Jesus is
Jesus.
He watches day and night. But I can go.
Go to him and pray.
Because he knows my every care. But just a little talk with Jesus will make it all right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him on about our troubles. He will hear our famous
cry, yeah.
And he will answer by and by. And when
you feel a little prayer will turn,
you will know a little fire is burning. You will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
We'll give the Lord a great big shout of praise. It'll make it all right this morning. Amen. You may be seated this morning. Hallelujah. I know he's a mighty good God this morning. Amen. So glad that you're with us. Amen. To worship the Lord in spirit and in truth this morning. God is a mighty good God. Amen. 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 I want Brother Jason to get ready to come and receive our tithes and our offerings this morning. I want to encourage you to continue to give. Be faithful. How many knows that God has blessed you to give? Amen. God has, amen, has strengthened us. Amen. And amen. As I said, we've lost several that, amen, that's left this world, amen, that was great tie payers, and we need everybody to stand in the gap and take up the slack. Amen. Hallelujah. God's a mighty good God. Amen. Brother Jason, give him and the Lord a good hand this morning.
As Pastor said, amen, it's a very important part of the service. You know, a lot of people may look at it as just the offering part of the service, but God said in Malachi, the Lord said that if you would give, he said, see, therefore, if I would not rebuke the devourer for your sakes, amen. So, you know, every time Satan comes in to rob our finances, Jesus steps up and said, wait a minute, that's my giver, amen. Hallelujah. So we have a lot of promises in the Lord as givers. I love the scripture where it says, I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor a seed beg bread. I want to read to you this morning, very familiar, chapter 9 of 2 Corinthians, verse 7. It says, every man according to his purposes in his heart. So let him give not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. And it says, and God is able. How many know our God is able this morning? Oh, hallelujah. Our God is able. Oh, hallelujah. How Satan wants to lie to us and tell us our giving is in vain or you can't afford to give. Amen. And oh, hallelujah. How it's such a blessing to give. I have to think about the woman who didn't have nothing and she is sitting in a congregation of rich people and they was casting in their abundance. And oh, there sat a little widow woman. Oh, hallelujah. You didn't have much, but Lord, she believed God. I mean, how many believe God this morning? Amen. And it said that, and the Lord said that her offering, her sacrifice was way more than those that give in their abundance. And so give out of your heart this morning and know that God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things. Amen. If the offering takers are come, we'll get ready to receive the offering. Brother Derek, you help us this morning. Reach your hands this way. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for our many blessings, Father. We thank you for meeting the needs through this week, Father, keeping our jobs, keeping our finances, Lord. And maybe things are hard, Father, but we thank you for the rain that's coming. We thank you for the increase that's coming, Father. We ask you to bless and multiply this as the fish in the loaves, Father, just as, Father. We thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
I worship.
Jesus, keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Oh, you're a way maker, miracle worker this morning. Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Oh, he's a way maker this morning, hallelujah. Light in the darkness, oh my God, that is who you are.
My God,
oh, you're a way maker. Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper. Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, meaning every heart. And I worship you. And I worship you. You are here. You're healing every heart. And I worship you. And I worship you. You are here. Touching every life. And I worship you. And I worship you. Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are this morning, hallelujah, you're a way maker. Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Oh, you're a way maker this morning, hallelujah. Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Light in the darkness, my God, that And you are here right now.
Lift your hands to Him. Hallelujah. Love
you.
You
are here.
Hallelujah.
You're meaning every heart. And I worship you. And I worship you. And you are here. You're turning lives around. And I worship you.
Come on,
and I
love you. Touch you this morning. Hallelujah. Let Him touch you this morning.
Yes, he is.
heaven knows he's our God this morning. Would you give him another shout of praise? Come on, let's make it sound like Holy Ghost Church in here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. He's an awesome good God this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Awesome job. Amen. God is a mighty good God this morning. Amen. Amen. I love what God spoke to me when we started Solid Rock Church. He said it'll be a place where lives are changed. God wants to change our lives. I mean, believe that. He wants to make a difference in our lives. Amen. His goodness and his mercy this morning. Amen. Again, I want to say it's good to have Brother and Sister Nail with us this morning. Amen. Before we change the service and go into Sunday school, I want him to just come and say something for the Lord. Amen. I don't know if Sister Sharon's able to sing for us this morning or not. Amen. But so good to have them. But I want Brother Larry to come and get ready to say something. Amen. And just, amen, appreciate him this morning. But I also want to say this morning, it is Brother Jeff's birthday tomorrow. And I don't want to forget that. I believe tomorrow's your birthday, isn't it? Yeah, I thought it was. So let's just sing happy birthday to Brother Jeff right quick, okay?
Happy birthday to you, a happy birthday to you. May you feel Jesus near every day of the year. A happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. May this be the best one you have had.
Happy birthday. Amen. I've come to a good conclusion. We give the small ones $5 or so for their birthday. I think anybody with 50 will start giving me $5. Hallelujah. But God is good. Amen. Would you give Brother Larry a good hand this morning? It's good to have him here this morning.
Praise the Lord. It's good to be here, isn't it? Good to be saved this morning. Got up this morning on purpose to come to church. Amen. Put my clothes on, wash my face to come to church. Got in an automobile and started driving to come to church. Amen. I'm telling you what, when I got to the town that the church was in, I got off because I wanted to go to church. My heart is in church. And I'm telling you what, anybody that's going to serve God, their heart is going to be toward their church. Amen. I believe that. And my brother, it's so good to be hearing the worship. And when I coming down to that parking lot, my Lord, I felt better. Amen. When I seen the church, I felt better. When I came into the driveway, I really started to feel good. But there was something special when I come into the house of God. Amen. That felt like church to me. And we started worshiping and loving God. I'll tell you what, that's what it's all about. You know what? I remember that one time I came and preached for y'all, and you was in a little church on the side of a hill. Amen. I'm telling you what, small beginnings, but if you stay faithful, you keep looking to God, you keep believing God will give you the desires of your heart. I remember when I first started, had a little bitty old church, and everybody said, let's build a church. I didn't want to for a while, and I thought, no, let's wait a while, but they kept insisting. Everybody gave me pledges, we'll help all summer long to build a church. So we got the money, we got all the material, laid it out on there, and guess what? I had a bunch of deacons said, well, we've worked enough for a while, and we just gonna take it easy. Boy, I think that's where I went bald. I started pulling, trying to get a catch, and you know what? We started building a church without them. Listen, you think you can stop the move of God, you're wrong. Amen. You might make it a little rough on somebody, but the church is going through. The church. Amen. That's what it's all about. Jesus came and died for the church. That's where we got to get back to. That's where we got to love him. You know, I carry pictures of our church, brother. I don't know if you ever seen them, but I feel toward our church like I do against some grandbabies. You know, preachers get to talking. I pull pictures out of our church, and I want you to see our sanctuary that we worked on. Say, y'all, you shouldn't be haughty. I ain't haughty, but I'm awful proud. Yeah. Amen. And I'll tell you what, it's good to be in the church here. And I look back there and I see old brother David, and I said, you can't beat him off. Amen. You go to church somewhere, there he is. My Lord, we've been in church all last week and enjoyed it. And I'll tell you, I'm thankful that you let us be here. I really enjoy worshiping with y'all. God bless you, my brother. God bless you, and blessings upon the church. Yeah.
Amen. Give him and the Lord a good hand. Amen. Amen. Two of the finest folks I know. Amen. I appreciate Brother Larry and Sister Sharon. Amen. Hallelujah. God's a mighty good God. Come on, give God a praise. Amen. Hallelujah. He's worthy of it this morning. He is worthy. Amen. Appreciate them this morning very much. Amen. Well, amen. You can go to your Sunday school this morning very quietly and reverently. Amen. Let the Lord bless you this morning. Thank a teacher this morning. Let's give the Lord another shout of praise, would you? I thought he might got started and wouldn't stop. I was hoping you was going to go home this morning. How many knows that God's a good God? Amen. Appreciate the goodness and the mercies of him this morning. Ryan, take this to Daniel. Come on, let's give the Lord one more shout of scripture. Give it to Daniel, the scripture. Now. Amen. He's a mighty good God. Brother Larry, amen. He already spoke really upon what I want to teach on this morning and share with you. How many knows sometimes we know certain things, but we have to be put in remembrance of those things. The Apostle Peter said that very thing, and if you understand that this morning, amen, you know, sometimes we have to reaffirm what we already believe. Somebody shout amen right there. How many knows sometimes we have to be reminded of the goodness and the mercies of an almighty God? Can I get a witness in this house? Come on. Let's give God a shout of praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Because he is worthy of all praise this morning. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's give God a shout of praise. Amen. Amen. Daniel, if you'll put up just a scripture, start with 2 Peter this morning, chapter number 1. 2 Peter chapter number 1, verse number 12. Just want to share this with you because God's a mighty good God. Somebody shout, God's a good God this morning. Amen. 2 Peter chapter number 1 there in verse number 12. Amen. This is just a reminder because sometimes, you know, we got reminders on our phone for this. We stick up notes on the refrigerator. Well, because we want to make sure we don't miss some things. Because if you miss some things, amen. I was talking to a guy a while back. And he said, amen, he said it took me 3 months to get to see my doctor. And if I miss this appointment, it'll probably be 3 months more before I can get to see him again. I said, wow. He said, if I really get in bad shape, he said, I got to go to the hospital and then to even get to hold that doctor. Amen. So he said, amen, one thing I cannot do is forget that appointment. How many knows this morning we can't forget certain things with God? The Bible says, wherefore I will not neglect to put you always in remembrance of these things, though you know them, and that you may be established in the present truth. See, sometimes we got to be stirred up in what we already know. How many believes that? Amen. A wife one time came to her husband. You know that sort of story. And amen. She says, honey, do you love me anymore? He said, well, of course you know I love you. She said, well, you have not told me in 30 years that you love me. He said, well, if I ever change my mind, I'll let you know. Somebody shout amen. But it'd be sure good to reaffirm it every now and then. Honey, I still love you. Somebody shout amen. So, you know, sometimes we need to just reaffirm our commitments with God this morning. Amen. Matthew chapter 22 and verse 36 this morning. So I was, amen. And this is the, you know, February is, you know, they got Cupid and they got, amen, this is Valentine week. And, amen, people's going to spend money on roses and flowers. And some of them don't even mean what they're doing. Somebody shout amen again. Amen. Hallelujah. But God's a good God. Amen. Notice he's a mighty good God. Amen. So, amen. Matthew chapter 22 this morning. Amen. Give God one more shout of praise as we get started here. And tell your neighbor, sometimes I just need to be reminded. How many of y'all ever need to be reminded? Hallelujah. God's a good God. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's go up to verse 34, Daniel. Go back up to verse 34 if you don't care with me this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. But when the Pharisees had heard that he had put the Sadducees to silence, amen, the Sadducees did not believe in the resurrection. And they asked Jesus a question. So the Pharisees, they wanted to get into the conversation, and they began to talk to Jesus. Amen. And they were gathered together, the Pharisees and the Sadducees. Well, that's a crowd. Somebody shout amen. And one of them, which was a lawyer of the law there, asked him a question, tempting him and saying, Master, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Now, watch it. There was the law. There was, amen, the Ten Commandments of those laws plus other laws that they had constituted in there. But, amen, they asked him, what is the greatest of all the laws? Amen. And Jesus said unto them, Thou shalt love the Lord. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God, read with me, now, I had a preacher one time to say this. He got on the radio and he said it. He said, that commandment is not true. Said, you cannot do that commandment. Well, now, if you can't do it, God wouldn't have put it in there. He said, you're to love the Lord your God with all thine heart, all thy soul, and with all thy mind. And what God is really saying here is this morning, you cannot be divided in love a little bit here and a little bit there. It has to be an unconditional love that you're totally sold out, that you love God more than anything else in this world. Can I get a witness in this house? Amen. So what God is saying to us, it's a love this morning that's undivided, that God is our number one priority. Amen. Now listen, when you get ready to die, you're really going to love this word right here. You're going to want to love the Lord when you're dying. But it sure be good to love him while you're living. Can I get a witness in here? Amen. Now, what if your wife looked at you today or day tomorrow and bought you a Valentine card and said, I love you most of the time? How would you take that? I love you when you're good to me. See, here's the thing. When God made Adam, Adam named all the animals and everything that he was doing. And when God made Adam, amen. And God gave Adam the authority over all the animals, and he saw the lion, how the lioness, he saw Mr. Elephant had Miss Elephant and all these things. He saw every one of the animals have a mate. But when it come to Adam, he turned around and he looked, and he did not have one. And Adam longed, or really Adam felt himself, he was missing something. And God caused a great sleep to come upon Adam. You ladies ought to really enjoy this. And when God caused a great sleep to come upon Adam, and God took from him a rib, and he made a woman. And God said, I'm giving you this woman. I'm giving you her as your helpmeet. Not your mate, your meat. And everywhere that you have a need, she's going to be there to supply that. The right wife is very important. Make sure you get the right one if you're going to get married. Because if you don't, you're going to have sorrows all the days of your life. Because you'll want to go to church and she won't, or vice versa. They'll want to love God. Come on, somebody. Amen. If you've got a good husband, pray for that man. You've got a good wife, pray for her. Can I get a witness? Amen. And see, amen. And really, amen, all that scripture really means is, amen, God took the other half of Adam and made Eve. So you're not complete till you have the right Eve. Somebody shout amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Now that don't mean that she's always going to agree with you, but amen, that means she'll direct you in the right ways when you need it. Somebody shout amen. Well, I preached a good message right there. Y'all missed part of that. But God's still good. Somebody shout amen. Jesus said unto them, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. Everybody shout unconditional, undivided love. Amen. When your heart is divided, you can sway and you're not sure which way you want to go. And God is saying, if you're going to love me, you're going to have to love me. Can I get a witness in here? Amen. Now, Brother Ronnie, one time, me and him, we cut up sometime, Brother Ronnie Lloyd. Amen. And I told you all that story, amen, that when I was dating Sister Jeannie, and one day before she really got serious, I was done serious, she said, if I ever marry somebody, I want to marry somebody like you. And I got to thinking about that. And I thought, why would you want to marry somebody like me when I'm the real thing? There ain't but one of me, and some of y'all should raise your hand and shout hallelujah to that. Thank you, Sister Doris. Really appreciate you. But God's still good. Somebody shout amen. Amen. But why would she want to marry somebody like me when the original is standing right there before her? You can't get no better than that. Some of y'all look at me sort of strange this morning. Amen. So, and she liked certain things about, but I don't know what made her say that. But one day, thank God, that woman woke up. Somebody shout amen. She was no longer looking for somebody like me. She found the real thing. And when you get a hold of Jesus, honey, you found the real thing, and there ain't nothing else like him. Can I get a witness in this house? Would somebody give God a shout of praise? Amen. Amen. Out there may be something like him, but it ain't him. Amen. It may promise you something, but it can't deliver to you. Amen. God's a good God. If any of y'all tell her what I said this morning, I know it's y'all. Somebody shout amen. But God's a good, mighty good God. Next verse, please. Amen. Amen. So we're going to talk about this morning, amen, about, you know, this is the season of Valentine and loving and heart-giving and all this. But you know what? The greatest thing you can ever do this morning is to love the Lord your God this morning. And this is the first and the greatest commandment, because nothing else will work right until you get the first thing right. If you get the corner out of line, the whole house is going to be out of line. How many understands that this morning? Amen. Is that right, Brother Buddy? Amen. No matter how good it is, it's still going to be, somewhere it's going to be off. Amen. But God's a mighty good God. Brother Buddy and I know some, amen, some guys that built, I don't know the guys, but we know the houses they built down that strip right before you get into Cave City down there. Amen. And amen. I mean, little houses, but man, you can tell they was no carpenters. You can drive down the road and see the roughness of them houses. How, am I telling the truth? Yes. Rough, oh man, I'm telling you. And every, oh man, we won't even go there because I don't even know the guys not knocking. But I know one thing, they were not carpenters, and I wouldn't want them to build me a good doghouse. Somebody shout amen. Hallelujah. So if you don't start out right, you can't end up right. Can I get a witness in this house? So the first commandment is, and the greatest of that, is to love the Lord our God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our mind, and with all of our strength. And somebody said, well, I know I love God like that. Amen. And listen, let me tell you something. And the second of this is to love thy neighbor as thyself. I was talking to some people, counseling them a while back, and amen, I was telling other folks this, and amen, amen, they got, amen, one lady, amen, her husband was not getting along, and she began to put all of her energy into her children, and amen, it was all about her kids, and then it was her grandkids. And I said, I want to tell you something. I said, now when, listen, I said, love your grandkids, love your children, but your husband should be before them. You did not take no vow to love your children. You didn't take no vow to love your grandchildren. Am I preaching to y'all? And anything you put in their place, it's out of order. Now, I didn't say not to love your children. I didn't say not.
Didn't say not to love your grandkids. I'd whoop three men for Isaac with one hand tied behind me. And Keith Strievel ain't even here to hear that. Somebody shout amen. But see, that man and a half would get turned on then. Somebody shout amen. But I wanted to understand something this morning. Amen. See, when things are not in the right contents, God can't use it like he needs to. Can I get a witness in here? If you're only dating a young lady for her looks or for ever what you can get, amen. Amen. It's wrong. God can't bless it. Am I running out of battery? Somebody shout amen. Thank you. He's a mighty good God this morning. Somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. So here is the thing. God says, I want to bless everything you have, but I want it in order. When God made this earth, he put everything in order. Satan is full of chaos, and he brings disorder to our lives. How many believes that? So here, when we get into this morning, and we begin to understand, amen, this undivided love with God, and amen, in 1 Samuel chapter 13 and verse 14, 1 Samuel 13 and 14, God makes a powerful statement, and this statement is so powerful, it's really shocking. Amen, I'll just keep this one, okay, thank you. Amen. It's really so shocking. It's hard to understand, amen, what I really want to bring out to you. And the Bible says this, but now thy kingdom, amen, shall not continue. God's talking, amen, to Saul, the king of Israel, and the Lord has sought him a man after his own heart. God has looking for a man after his own heart. Amen. I want you to understand something. Now go to Acts chapter 13 and verse 22, I believe it is. Acts 13 and 22. God is saying, and he confirms this again, amen, when he removed him, which was Saul, he raised up unto them David to be their king, to whom he also gave testimony and said, I have found a man, or I found David, the son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. How many of y'all with this morning, like when, amen, you died and on your tombstone, you put an epitaph there, amen, he was a man or a woman after God's own heart. Brother, you can't get no better than that as to be after the heart of God. Somebody will shout amen right there. You get after the heart of God, you'll get everything in your life right. Can I get a witness? Woo! Somebody will shout hallelujah now. Amen. Amen. And this heart, amen, of David's was going to fulfill all of the will of God. Now, David failed. David messed up. David done some things. But David knew how to pray. David knew how to repent. David knew how to get up. And David knew how to fulfill the plan of God. Every one of us has failed in here, but you can't lay there. You can't regret it. You got to get up and say, God, you still got a plan for my life. Some more shout amen. Now, I told a guy this one day, and he said, boy, wish I had heard that before now. He just got in church. Never, amen. His marriage it fell apart. And I said, you know how you to love your wife. And now we've all come short. I want to instruct you just a little bit this morning, amen. I have failed. You have failed probably, and amen. But you know how you to love your wife. Come here, I'll tell you. This is gonna help you. It'll help her to remind you. Okay. He is to love Heather as Christ. Now you got to understand. I don't love no woman that much, then you don't need to be fooling with her. Now, you're going to love her enough that you're going to give yourself for her. You're willing to bleed, suffer. If I didn't know I was in the right place, I think I was in the wrong place. You're to suffer. What did Jesus do? He went all the way to a bloody cross for his church. Now, that's how I'm supposed to love my wife. Now, I've come up that short. Come on, somebody. But I keep striving to be what I'm supposed to be. Because I'm the representation of Christ. It's a good time to preach this. Amen. So anytime things are going, you know, God, I'm to love her enough that I'm willing to suffer. I'm willing to go through anguish. I don't have time to get into all that. I'm willing to even to lay my life down for my wife. That's in your Bible. Thank you, sir. And you know what we most time do? We fuss and argue over the most senseless little things. I'm going to have my way or die. You can get it, but honey, you may die doing it too. Come on, somebody. I've counseled people that fussed over which way the toilet paper went on the hanger. That's a truth. It's supposed to come off on the front side. Others want it on the back side. I've had men and women, I've had husbands and wives have a serious argument over which way the toilet paper comes down. Now, that's the truth. I had one to get so mad, his wife knows to put, amen, the brownies in the 8x10 pan. And she put it in the 11x13. And if the brownies don't turn out right, and they had a big fuss and a fight that they didn't sleep together because over a brownie pan. Honey, forget the brownies. Y'all hear what I'm saying? I'm afraid to sleep by myself. Forget the brownies. I don't care if they're thin, if they're gooey. It don't matter to me. Said I get a witness in here. I don't think y'all really hear me this morning. Amen. Amen. But, you know, we've got to prove, amen, and we're going to stand our ground. But you know what, friend, this morning, I'd rather say, God, I love you more. Amen. Can I get a witness in here? Listen, God's always right. I don't care what I think about it. Don't care what somebody else says about it. Don't care who I get it off the internet from. If God's word says it, it's right regardless of what anybody says. Amen. Amen. I've heard some things that's, amen. Hallelujah. And you know, these some things the devil just uses against us. But I don't want an undivided love with God. Amen. I love God when things are going good. I'm going to serve God while things are good. But man, when things get bad and, amen, the troubles come, I can't feel God and everybody's around me shouting. I go to church and I feel like a hypocrite. Amen. I don't know what to do. I'll say, Mr. Devil, I'm going to tell you one thing. I've been bought by the blood. I'm saved. I'm sanctified. And devil, it may be a hard time and I may be walking through the darkest valley, but I'm going to serve you because you love me and you proved it to me at Calvary. How many knows he did this morning? Amen. Somebody shout love this morning. Amen. Now, David was a man after God's own heart. Amen. What are we saying here, after God's own heart? What is the heart of God? Listen, the heart of God is clean, the Bible says. It's pure. It's loving. It's merciful. It's gracious. Can I get a witness in here? Amen. For God's only, amen, can be touched, amen, by his heart this morning. God is not subject, amen, or to influence by any extreme or external factors out there. God only listens to his heart. Can I get a witness? He says what he's intended to say, amen, for it's all right with his heart. God says this. God says this. I'm not a pretender. If I say something to you, if I tell you I love you, I love you. Now, that don't always work with me. I can tell you I love you, and you treat me the wrong way enough, and I'm going to start wondering if I love you or not. Come on, y'all lighten up and smile just a little bit. Huh? I love her, but I'm telling you, I've about had enough of her too. I didn't hit but two of y'all, did I? Come on. Vice versa, you know the story. I love him, but he's on my last nerve. It'd be better for you to go take a walk. Can I get a witness in the house? Come on. A long one at that. Can I get a witness in the house? But God says, I love you, and there's nothing, now listen to me, there's nothing you can do for God not to love you. Now, God can be grieved with your sin. God can hate the sin. But God cannot change his mind on loving you. God will love you regardless.
If you die and walk away from him and walk into Christ's eternity, God said, I loved you. And I died for you as much as I died for anybody else. Now, that's a love that it's hard to you can't really explain it. It's I love you that much. All that you did in your life, I forgave you. I never brought it back up to you. Is that right? Is that right? What he done, didn't he? He changed you from who you was to who you are today because he loves you. My God, I'm preaching good to somebody in here this morning. And David began to find out, amen, to love God is to love his word. You're going to love good preaching even when he gets on you a little bit. Can I get a witness in the house? Psalms 119. This is where a man's after God's own heart is. Psalms 119, amen, and verse 47. This is what David says in Psalms 119 and verse 47. I'm trying to tell you, when you love God, you're going to love his word. When you love God, you're going to love to go to the house of God. My brother done said it this morning. When you love God, there's something about getting with God's people. That's, amen, it's amazing when you feel get around them and feel the uplift of God. And when he had removed, amen, oh, amen, I'm sorry, we still in the same verse here. Amen, Psalms 119 and verse, amen, 47, 119 verse 47. Amen, David said this, I will delight myself in thy commandments which I have loved. You know what David did? He loved God's word. Can I get a witness in here? Amen, this word you hide in your heart, it'll keep you, friend. He said, my hands also will I lift up unto thy commandments, yea, which I have loved, and I will meditate in thy statutes. What God is saying this morning, I love this word. I love it more than a magazine. I love it more, amen, than some story. I love it because there's life in this book. There's victory in this book. It'll tell you how to live and have some peace of mind. I've never seen a generation, I've never seen children today, amen, no peace in their heart. They don't know what to do. They don't know how to connect. All they know how to do is sit there and do this. Amen. Let me give you some more good advice. When you and your wife go out to eat, leave them phones in the car. Don't sit there at that table and do this the whole time. If you'll listen to me a little bit, you won't have to spend time with the lawyer's office. Well, I'm preaching real good, y'all. You know, and some people's never been raised to do that. Amen. But I'm giving you instructions now. Amen. And I'm asking God all the time. Hey, here's something I tried to do one time. I tried to change Wayne Keith. Now, I'm going to tell you, that's the hardest fellow I've ever had to deal with in my life is Wayne Keith. I tried to change that booger, and every time I let him out of the cage, he'd act up the same way. I thought he's going to behave now. Show out again. Come on, y'all. I didn't say a thing about y'all. I said Wayne Keith. Amen. How many of y'all ever promised? Lord, I promise. The next thing you know, right back in that same old rut again. I said, God, what to God? What did I say, God? I made a pretty bad mess of this stuff. And God, I read in your word that you're able to transform a man. You're able to change him. You're able to help him. You're able to do things for him that he can't do for himself. And God, I need your help to be the husband, to be the father. God, to be the man of God that I need to be. God, would you change me? God, would you change me in my spirit? Now, I'm saved, don't get, but I still need to be working on in my character. Anybody here with me besides me? Huh? Amen. Hallelujah. God, I still need to improve. I still need to mature. I don't want to say I've reached the plateau that I'm here. Amen. Amen. God, I'm still reaching out for the things of you this morning. I say, God, change me. Help me this morning. And every day I get up, I pray that God, help me today. Help me to grow, change me, work in me, that I can inch by inch, every what it takes, step by step. But I'm going to gain today and a little more tomorrow. Can I get a witness in this house? Amen. Amen. It's going to take the hand of God. Amen. And you can. Love him and get full of him more than anything else in this world. Don't you going to be as miserable to the day you die.
And I've been miserable before. Somebody shout amen. Amen. Listen what David says. Amen. Psalm 73 and verse 25. Amen. Psalm 73 and verse 25. David, amen, he's talking to God. Amen. And David has searched everything out. Amen. And David, amen, is having a hard time. And he realizes one thing. He realizes this. Whom have I? Who do you have? If you ain't got God, what do you have? I talked to a man. I told you all this story before. Talked to a gentleman one day. Amen. I don't know how many million dollars he had. I don't know how many thousands of dollars he probably had in his billfold. He had probably, I don't know how many girlfriends. He had a wife. He had, listen, I'm driving what they call a jalopy. He tore up more vehicles than I could wear out in a lifetime. He had some of the nicest vehicles. I have to pray sometimes for my tires not to blow out going to church. He'd take tires off that didn't need to be taken off. Now I'm looking at him and I'm looking at me. He comes to me one day, tears streaming down his cheeks. He said, I got this gun. He said, I'd like to blow my brains out. And I'm thinking, God, he's got all this money. He's got a magnificent home. He said, I meet my wife. He said, we're having trouble. He said, I meet my wife on the road. He said, I'd like to cut my car right in front of her and kill us both. He said, I hate living. I'm miserable. I ain't got no good tires on my car, and I'm driving a jalopy. But, honey, you shake hands with a poor boy that owns everything. Amen. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. If you ain't got peace, you ain't got nothing. Can I get a witness in this house? Things don't make you who you are. I see people try to put on for, amen, they've got, amen, I got this and I got that and I got, amen, that don't make you who you are. If you ain't got God, you ain't much of anything. Amen. David said, whom have I in heaven but thee? There's none upon the earth that I desire besides thee. Friend, when you get a hold of God, it makes all the difference in the world. Can I get a witness in this house this morning? Amen. See, when Jesus, or when the young rich ruler came running to Jesus, amen, he said, well, Lord, what can I have to do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus said, sell all that you have. I wondered if he'd have been willing to sell if the Lord would have told him that. Think about it. Are you willing to lay down your pride to have the peace of God? We talk about this rich young ruler all we want to, but pride will keep you out of heaven as much as anything else will. Haughtiness, self-will, stubborn, obstinate. Y'all want to preach with me for a few more minutes? Am I willing to lay down and say, hey, when Nathan walked in that throne room, amen, to David, amen, and David was going to say, have you got a word for me? And Nathan says, yeah, I got a word for you. Amen. He said, I got a little story to tell you. Amen. Rich man got plenty of flocks over there. Amen. And a poor man down the road there. Amen. Had took care of this little baby lamb from the time of his birth. And they grew it up and their children loved it. Amen. Everybody, it was precious to them. And the rich man, amen, his guest came in. And the rich man went down and got the poor little lamb from the poor man and killed the poor man's lamb. Oh, David was up throwing off that coat. Hold on, let me go get him. Come on, he was. David was upset over that because David was a shepherd. David knew, amen. David knew them little few little sheep he had. He killed a bear and a lion for them few little sheep. And when a rich man that had flocks out there and he went down to the poor man and killed his little lamb, oh, man, that upset David. David said, oh, God, let me go get him. Come on, church. David said, that man should pay for that. That little bony finger of Nathan said, thou art the man. David all of a sudden realized what he began to do, what he had done. My God, can I preach to somebody in here this morning? You're the man. And you know what David began to do? David said, well, if that woman hadn't been taking a bath on that roof, it's not my fault.
David never blamed Bathsheba for nothing. Now, my worst problem is I like to blame somebody else. Come on, y'all. You know why Seth won't change? It's Shelly's fault. I got a witness in here this morning. Somebody shout him. I'm just using y'all. Am I right? Now, we don't like that sometimes. Now, I'm not saying that Seth don't have his faults or Shelly don't have her faults, but amen, Seth got to work on Seth. Because if Seth works on... Anybody got a picture of theirself? Anybody carry a picture of yourself? I ain't got a billfold this morning. Amen. No, I need a natural picture. I need a photograph. Anybody got a photograph of yourself? Okay, let me just use that as an example. Amen. Try to change that person, that photograph. You can't. Everybody raise your hand and say, he's preaching. Go ahead. See, when I try to change you, instead of working on me, all I'm going to do is make you hate me. And you're not going to listen much. If I work on me to be what I need to be, well, still preaching good. Now, that don't mean my wife can't instruct me, but I've got to work on me. Can I get, that means I need to instruct her, but I've got to help me. Somebody shout amen. Raise your hand and shout, I need a heart this morning. I want a heart for God this morning. And when David, amen, when Nathan walked in and said, thou art the man, David said this, go to Psalms chapter 51. Listen to the heart of a man that said he's after God. How many of y'all want a heart after God this morning? How many wants a heart? And the first thing with a heart after God is a heart that will say, I'm wrong, I repent, I'm willing to change by the grace of God. Come on, somebody. Amen. And brother, I believe the revival that's starting in this land is coming with repentance, that we're coming back. God, I shouted, but I've got things in my life that I don't want to deal with. I've covered it up, but today we're going to dig it up, going to deal with it, and get some victory over it. Tell your neighbor God loves you. And I want to tell you something. I wouldn't hurt you this morning. I wouldn't do anything to hurt you. But amen, I'm just trying to tell you, you're going to have to work and you're going to have to try and humble our hearts before God and get full of God before you can do anything else. I'm preaching to me. The devil's out to get every one of us, to destroy us. Am I telling you the truth? See, it's the nature of the devil to do that. Man was coming down a mountainside one time. Amen. It was cold and rainy and dreary. Amen. And a snake on the side. This is just a story. But amen. He was coming down the side of the mountain. He seen a big old rattlesnake laying there. The rattlesnake, amen. He looked at him and he was all coiled up and couldn't move. And the snake said, amen, pick me up and carry me down to the bottom of the mountain. And the man said, no. He said, no, sir. I know you. I know that you'll bite me. He said, no, I won't bite you. Just pick me up and carry me down to the foot of the mountain. And he convinced the man to pick him up, put him in his coat, and carry him down to the foot of the mountain. The man got down to the foot of the mountain. Amen. He reached in his coat pocket. Amen. Pulled out the snake, and the snake bit him. The man looked at the snake and said, you told me you wouldn't bite me. He said, you know who I was before you picked me up. You mess with the devil, and when I mess with the devil, I was the one that gets burnt. I'm not trying to be critical. I'm just trying to wake us up this morning because the devil's after every one of us. David said this. Go back to verse number one. Go back to verse number one. Hallelujah. That's the verse I think I told you 10, but amen, 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 hallelujah. God is a mighty good God. This is what David said, amen, after, amen, that Nathan the prophet came to him and he said, have mercy on me, O God, according to thy loving kindness and according to thy multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgression. The first thing that David started doing, amen, and there's three different types of sin in the scriptures if you read them. I don't have time to go into them this morning. There's transgressions, there's iniquities, and there's sins. Now, they're all wrong, but they have different values, how they do it. And I don't have time to go into those this morning. I may teach that on that next Sunday. Amen. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Don't tell the other. The twistedness. How we can weave lies when we get into trouble. God. How many of y'all have made a bigger mess after you sin? Man, somebody said honesty was a good policy. I said, no, sir, honesty is not a good policy. It's the only policy. Getting warm in here, ain't it? Amen. Because you can't build on falsehood. You can't do it. David says, I acknowledge my transgressions. We are again, sins, transgressions, iniquities. And my sin is ever before me. Now, here's what David was saying. Back up here. I want to clarify this scripture right here. Amen. You've got to understand one thing. That my sin is ever before me. And what it was, the 18 months or so that David was living in that sin, he never got up a day without that sin slapping him in the face. But when he got forgiveness for it, and God washed it away, and God took it away, it could no longer do that to him. And you're free this morning by the grace of God. Your sins can't haunt you anymore because they're washed away. They're in the past. They're in the sea of forgiveness. Somebody shout amen. And if the devil tries that, you say, Mr. Devil, I know my sins are washed in the blood. And when you start talking about the blood, the devil's got to pack up and go. Somebody ought to shout amen. That ought to make any of us want to shout hallelujah. Amen. Because our sins are gone this morning. And if you bring up your sins after, now maybe you tell somebody something, amen, to encourage them, to help them. But, amen, if you bring your sins up with guilt in it, you're saying the blood was not good enough for your sin. So your sin, amen, God washed your sins away like it is anybody else's or mine. And there's no sin bigger than the power of the blood of Jesus. Now that ought to make some of y'all, that gives you hope this morning, church. And I love this. When I've had folks to talk to me different things, and the other spouse will say, "Honey, I forgive you. You can't hear no greater words than I forgive you." And when God says He forgives you, that's the greatest word you ever hear in your life. I've been forgiven. By the anybody been forgiven of sins here beside me? Amen. Aren't you glad you don't have to live with your past? Aren't you glad you don't have to carry that thing around like a ball and a chain? Heard a man say one time, he said, I'm getting ready to get married, so I'm marrying my ball and chain. I'm thinking, if you're marrying a ball and chain, I told somebody a while back, they said, I'm not married. I said, well, only thing I can tell you is what the Bible says. If you're not married, you have not found a good thing yet. Because he that findeth a wife. I got somebody telling me, God, I wish he'd say something else. Come on, church. But it's truth. Come on, it's still the truth. So you, every one of you ladies should have stood up and raised both hands. He's preaching a good name. When you find a wife, you find a good thing. That's the word of God. You found a good thing, brother, I'm telling you. Somebody shout amen. I used to sing this song. Listen, I came up and, amen, I loved, amen, before I got saved, I loved the, amen, the Chuck Berry song, you know, the thing that, and he is singing, I found my thrill on Blueberry, Blackberry, what was it? I got to think, well, honey, Chuck Berry, you ain't got nothing on Wayne Keith. I got to singing, I found my thrill on Rowena's Hill. That's where I found her, actually, up on a little hill. Somebody shouted. Who else found them? You don't have to leave, Sister Jessica, you fine? Somebody shouted. Where'd you find your thrill at? On Burton Ridge, didn't you? Somebody shout amen. But God's still good. Somebody shout amen. Isn't God good this morning? Amen. Next verse, please. I got to hurry. Amen. Oh, God's good this morning. I want to be after God's heart this morning. I want to love His law. I want to love Him. I don't want this love that I'm all time torn between loving God and loving the things of this world. Somebody shout amen. Oh, God, I want to, as Mother Larry said, I want to go to the house of God. Oh, I love going to the. Somebody shout amen. Amen. It means something, church. Can I get a witness in this house this morning? Amen. God's a good God this morning. Amen. Somebody shout, God's a good God this morning. Amen. David's desire. Amen. Next verse, Dan. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. David's desire was to serve God and do God's will. Can I get a witness in here this morning? Amen. David was a repentant man. He said this, Against thee only have I sinned. Now watch what David is saying here. God, I've did this against you and done this evil in thy sight. Now this is a man praying, folks. He ain't trying to smooth it over and make any excuses. He's just being plain raw out of it with all landed all right out there saying, God, I don't have any excuses for nothing. I did it. How many of y'all want to get close to God? How many of y'all want to get close to God? Don't go to God in your holiness. You go to God in His mercies. And saying, God, now, amen, not belittling yourself, saying, God, without you, I'm nothing. And done evil in thy sight, that thou may be justified when thou speaketh, and be clear when thou judge. God, you've judged me, and it's right. How many of y'all want to see a revival break out? I'm not looking for a revival break out in church. I'm looking for a revival break out in you. Huh? So I want revival break out in me. The whole month of January, even into February, I've been humbling and seeking God and crying out to God. Oh, God, I got to get closer to you, God. We're living in a very serious time that people, amen, are cool and indifferent and even in backslidden shape and think they're okay. When preaching upsets me, I'm not okay. When I'm afraid to hear somebody preach, I'm not okay. When I'm afraid to, amen, I want to run out the door before the preacher gets back to the door, amen, and I don't want to shake his hand because I'm afraid he may say something. I'm not okay. I'm not okay, amen. He can't help me. No. Listen, somebody needs to help us sometimes. Be that mediator between. Can I get a witness? God's still good. I'm preaching good. Behold, I was shaping iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. He said, it's because sin I did what I did. I have a nature of sin. That's what David was saying. That's what he had. All the scars that I have in me is because of sin. Y'all hear me? I come that close to spending a life sentence in a penitentiary. Because of sin. That's right. Hear what I'm saying to you? Oh, now, honey, you tell me how good you was all you want to. I lived with David Keith for 16 years, 17 years. Somebody shout amen. I know that guy. Somebody shout amen. And he needed to be saved. Somebody shout amen. He used to take that. We had a little brother called Timmy. And we used to aggravate him. And now, I don't know if it's true or not. But he said David used to put a pillow over his head and want to smother him. Then they want to blame me for it. Somebody shout amen. You remember that, David? Huh? Tuck two of you. Well, you and him then. Oh. No, I believe you was talking about me, wasn't you? Yeah, I thought you was. Now listen. Oh. Well, I got to talk about somebody else besides me. God's still good. How many knows God's still good? Amen. See, we're all shaped like that. But you know what? God can change us. Amen. Next verse, please. Hurry. I got to hurry. Amen. But you know what? I bragged on my brother David the other day how God had changed him and delivered him and made a new person out of him. Amen. Makes all the difference. Lisa, you're not the same person you used to be. Amen. Hallelujah. God's good. Behold, thy desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden parts thou shalt make me to know wisdom. See, what God is saying is, if you allow, God will shine light in you. God will shine light. when you can see that you've been saved. How many of y'all saved this morning? And you know that your blood's been applied. But God, I want to go after God this morning. How many of y'all want to serve God this morning? How many wants a passion for God this morning? How many wants a greater desire for God this morning? I don't want a cooling off. Amen. I have people all the time tries to get me to cool off. That's the truth. They'll encourage me. Well, you done preached 40 years. You need to slow down now. I mean, you don't need to preach as hard as you used to preach. People tell me that. I just look at them like, well, you're funny. Somebody shout amen. God's still good. God's still good. I said he's still good. Amen. Friday night, I got up, went to bed Thursday night. I felt real, real bad. I just felt so bad I couldn't hardly put one foot in front of another. I didn't know what was going on to a point. And amen. And I was just dragging. Amen. I was just, amen. I know that wasn't me. I couldn't find that other gear. You ever looking for the other gear and you can't find it? Man, I just couldn't get it. And I told Gene, I said, man, I don't know why. I can't hardly go. Well, she said, you're a priest and you've run and you've done everything. I said, no, it's not that. I went to bed and I didn't feel good. And beside my head was a hurting. And it just, oh, man, I just felt real bad. I wasn't sick. And sometime in the middle of the night, I woke up. And I must have been going through this for a few minutes or something. I don't know. And I was minding in a panic mode. I had quit breathing. And I couldn't get my breath. And when I got up, I still couldn't get my breath. I couldn't get my breath. And I was fighting to breathe. And I'm about that bed. And son, I found me a gear to get in. Somebody shout amen. And I couldn't get my breath. And I still couldn't breathe, and I couldn't swallow. I couldn't get any air. And I went through that house trying to get myself, amen, trying to get me a light on in there and trying to do this. And I tried to swallow, and I couldn't swallow. And my face was all swelled. My lymph node was all pushed out. My throat was hard as a rock. And somehow I'd got a... I'd done this a couple years ago. I got it must have been a massive amount of infection pocket in my lymph node and behind my throat there, and it swelled my throat shut. And I couldn't breathe. I couldn't swallow. Oh, God. Now I'm thinking, God, I got to go preach here in about 10, 12 hours. I got to go preach, and I can't even swallow. I laid my hands on me, and I said, devil, you're not going to keep me from serving God. You're not going to keep me from preaching. And I sat for a couple hours and tried to, amen. And I finally sat back on the couch, and amen, after a while, dozed back off, amen, amen. And, oh, man, that big old knot back there. What's that little thing that hangs down there? Now, what is it? I just gonna make sure I gotta say it right before I say it. I'll tell you what I'm gonna let you do. I'm gonna let you say it in case it's not correct.
Uvula.
Uvula. Is that what it is? A uvula. Well, I'm like this door. It's my that thing that hangs down back there. I took that little flashlight and I couldn't see that. It wasn't there. It wasn't there. I'm like, oh, God. I'm telling y'all the truth. I didn't have it. Ain't no worries that. And I got to feeling something back in the back of my throat and back of my tongue back in there somewhere. It's something I couldn't get rid of. It's something back there on it. And it was that little hanging down on the back of my tongue. They said, you can't go to church and preach tonight. You can't go to church and do that. That thing bursts, is ruptured, you're going to be in bad shape. And he goes, amen, because I've been through that thing one time. And it was horrible. Amen. But you know, I said, God, I read in the Bible where these men sacrificed their lives to serve you. And God, I'm just going to go and see what you can do. God, I'm going to press on just a little bit. God, I'm going to give you the chance. We quit too quick sometimes. We make excuses too fast. Amen. And you know what? By the grace and the mercies of God, when I got to church, God began to touch my spirit and my body. And I stand here this morning by the grace of God, healed in the name of Jesus. Amen. Because God's a good God. But sometimes you got to desire something more than anything else. God, I desire to serve you. And I thought, God, I believe you told me to go, Brother Jimmy Lee's. And God, I know you spoke into my heart a message. You spoke to me a message. I believe that message is to be delivered. Can I get a witness in this house? There's many times that you need to hear a message, and the devil does everything he can to keep you away from that message. Because that message is a life-giving message to you. Can I get a witness in the house? David said, purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Go, amen. Next verse, quick. I'm not going to get done with it this morning, but God is good. Make me to hear. Oh, God. You know, this morning, I have prayed this prayer before. God, I got to hear joy again. God, I got to have gladness in my bones again. Now, I don't know if people take pleasure in being miserable or not, but I don't like being there. And God, if it takes repenting, God said, I'm sorry. God, repent. God, shape me, mold me, make me, break me, everything you see fit. But God, I want the freedom to know you and the free pardon of sin. Can I get a witness in this house? Amen. God's a good God this morning. God, why not be on fire for God? Why not have a zeal for God? Can I get a witness? I've seen people just at a ball game. They had such zeal for a ball game. And I'm not knocking that. Everything has its place. I'm not knocking that. But when we come to the house of God, we ought to have something, amen, worth shouting about and have a zeal. God, look what you have done. My God, I can give. I don't have to feel something for me to raise my hands and thank you, God. God, you let me live today. God, you let me walk today on two good legs. God, you give me two good hands to raise. And God, you've got to bless me in such a and pour out such a magnificent. I even raise my hand and say, thank you. That's not gratitude. That's called selfishness. Amen. Somebody shout amen. Amen. If your wife fixed you supper and you sat there watching television, she even brings it to you. Y'all are, well, I didn't really care for that. You need to do without about 3 days. Woo! Next food you get, honey, you'll like them black-eyed peas. Somebody shout amen. Oh, I preached good just then. Huh? It's a truth. She cleans the house. Woman, what have you done all day? She cleaned the house. She did all these things. But you know, sometimes we're not very thankful. And I'll tell you something else I love. I love when I'm gone all day, I come home and Jean's at the door. Talk about a good time. And she says, she puts her arms around me, she says, it's good to see you. I love you. I missed you. Honey. It beats hard. Where have you been? You got a choice. Hello? You home? Food's in the refrigerator. I'm preaching real good, ain't I?
Derek, you found a good thing when you found Mary. Thank you. It's the truth. How many believes that? Amen. That's good preaching. Amen. And you know what? Me and Brother Buddy went to a men's meeting one day, and I couldn't find nothing to preach. Oh, God. I'm going to close with this. And all them guys was there, and it was just a men's meeting. And, man, I wanted to preach something spiritual to them men. And, man, you know, let them know. And all the thing God would give me was, husbands, love your wives. I went down there and preached that message, didn't I? Before I got home, the phone was a-ringing. From them ladies. Them men went home, and some of them was on the verge of leaving them. This is the truth. Some of them had not got flowers in years. Some of them got flowers and different things, and they called me and want to know what I preached to them men. Because they all left out that day, and the pastor and his wife, she'd been going through some things. He told us this, didn't he? And they had not been getting along at all. And he went home and changed his attitude because of what his wife was going through. Got a little understanding. And that whole church, they want me to come back again and preach another message. Somebody shout amen. But you can't believe it. Am I telling the truth? Amen. Now, we've all come up short there. We've all done. Amen. But I won't be a man after God's own heart this morning. How many of y'all won't be a man after God's own heart? How many a woman after God's own heart? It doesn't matter. Amen. I want that yearning, that desire. As I close with this statement, Psalms 42, Daniel, verse 1. Amen. This is one of my favorite scriptures. I love this scripture. I could quote it to you, but I want you to see it and read it. Amen. Amen. As the heart panteth, as that deer is desiring that water brook. David says, my soul thirsteth after thee, O God. I'm thirsty for you, God. As that deer runs for that water brook, God, I want to run towards you and drink of your mercy and your loving kindness. And see what I am today. I am by the grace of God. I'm not here because I'm good. I'm here because of the mercy and the grace of an all. And you are too this morning. I don't care how much you in God. It's by the mercy and the grace of God. Next verse. Come to the music, please. Amen. David said, my soul thirsteth for God, for the living God, when I shall come and appear before God. Somebody shout amen this morning. Amen. As you give your wife flowers this week or candy this week, amen. Bring God something. Give God something. Oh, God, why are we coming here tonight? And every one of us, our hearts are yearning for more of God. How many like to come here tonight and say, God, my heart's just yearning for you. I don't come to hear the singing. I'm not coming. God, I just come to cry holy to you. I just come to raise my hands to you. I just come to thank you for your goodness. How many like to do that tonight? Amen. Amen. Sister Carol's been in Lexington with Jaden for, 10, 11 days, something like that? 15 days. Boy, you sure do miss her, don't you? Probably didn't know how much you did miss her until now. I mean, to a point. Amen. Makes a difference, don't it? Makes a difference. Listen, folks, I can't understand how people can walk away from God and get cold on God and not miss that. Something got to be numb to something. What it is, you find something else for a few moments of pleasure that's entertaining. Somebody said, the moment I quit serving God, things started getting better. I said, yeah, they sure did. Only to run into a storm that you can't get out of because you don't have any kind of direction. Certainly, things go real good for a while until he gets you to that place. See, the nature of Satan is to steal. And that means, the word steal means this. To feel the loss of. See, that's what Satan wants you to do. He wants to feel the loss of something that's irreplaceable. Can I get a witness? David said, I've walked away, but I'm coming home. Can I get a witness in this house? Hallelujah. Amen. Tonight or today, I want you to say, God, God, I just want to draw closer. God, there's a revival moving right now. There's anointing of God. And I may not be as young as I once was, but I can have the fire of God to burn just as deep in my heart today as it's ever burned. Amen. I may not have the endurance that I once had, but I tell you what, I have the fire of God that can still burn as deep in my soul. Can I get a witness in here? God's a good God, and I love Him this morning. Would you this morning just stand to your feet and say, God, I just want to love You. God, I want to love You more than my necessary food. God, I want to hunger for You. I want to thirst for You. Singing, oh, how I love Jesus. Come on, would you love Him just for a moment this morning? Come on, would you love Him just for a moment? Hallelujah. Amen. Hope I said something this morning that would burn in your spirit. God, help me to be a better person. God, help me to change this morning. Amen. How many of y'all want to change this morning? And you can by the grace of God. You can. You can change this morning by the grace of God. Singing, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh. Come on, lift your voices to Him. Come on, just give Him something this morning. Come on. This altar's open if you're lost. If you're cold and indifferent this morning. If you're not walking close to God this morning. Would you like to come and say, Lord, I just need You this morning. God, I just need a new touch of You. God, there's other loves bidden for me this morning. But God, You're the greatest of all this morning. Come on, love Him this morning, would you? Come on, this altar's open. Hallelujah. Sing it.
Jesus.
Tell Him this morning. Tell Him this morning.
How I love Jesus. Because He first loves me.
One more time. Everybody, one more time. Come on, sing it with passion. Sing it with passion this morning. Sometimes I've been busy or she's been busy. She's got something else to do. I say, honey, I'm leaving. And I never leave without giving my wife a kiss. Because you never know, you may never come back. That's my philosophy. And one day, I said, honey, I'm going. And I give her a peck. She said, what was that? Church. You know, sometimes we get in a hurry with God. God said, what was that? When you need to stop and say, shh. Just say, Lord, I love You. I love You. Can we sing it one more time to Him? Don't give Him a peck. Let's sing it with passion.
How I love Jesus.
Come on, sing it, Brother Austin.
Jesus.
Yes, God.
Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because He first loved me.
only love you because of one thing. Because you first loved me and you touched my heart with it. Now listen, don't feel bad if you